Welcome to a new showcase. I'm going to be showcasing, as you saw, 18 Wheels of Steel Convoy. This is my favorite game from the series because it's a pretty simple game, and it's not as hard, and the controls of the trucks are actually quite nice.
Yeah, they are.
They're more realistic in my opinion than American Long Haul.
I've got American Long Haul. I've played it quite a lot too, but
yeah, I just don't like it as much as this.
And it also seems that this has better features.
There's just one little thing about this game. It's older. Hey, you just run a red light.
It's older than
American Long Haul, which is kind of weird because this is better.
Okay, so I've tinkered around with the things already, the options.
We have a little showroom thing we can show. Continue. And we can
I haven't played free any trucks because I just installed this game.
But basically, you've got, you know, a selection of trucks that you can look at already.
This is actually one of my favorite trucks.
It's based off on Peterbilt,
and it's called Pacific. It's quite fun. It's based off the Peterbilt.
I don't know what the name of the Peterbilt is, but it's Optimus Prime, basically.
So if you're Transformers fan, this is Optimus Prime.
Right.
I don't really know what this is.
I'll show you the different color scheme you can get for it.
Awesome.
Oh, there's a patch for this game. You can download that from the internet. I haven't done that yet, so
that may be for next year. Thing with that
patch is that there is an invisible wall
somewhere,
and that fixes that.
This is basically a big caravan on wheels.
Good.
Okay, so let's jump right into this. This is probably the I think this is the truck that you start off with from the default. It's really hard speaking, and if I'm blowing into the mic, I'm very sorry. I don't mean to.
You can also
showcase these trailers. Well, there's a lot to see in these trailers. There are also double trailers, as I seem to remember. But in this game, I have yet to find that out how that works. But in the other game, that's just called, that's actually, I know how that works. No other double trailer.
Yes, a double trailer.
So basically, you have a dry van.
It would be very awesome to
me. I don't know if that works, so we'll find out. But I never got that far. Basically, you know, they're selling gold.
There's a lot to play for.
This is a house on wheels. It's basically a big caravan, but it's a house on wheels. So,
yeah.
It's more house-like than caravan.
Mobile office, also awesome.
You can get your
body checked and stuff.
And oil, iron, pipes, potatoes, grocery.
And then here's some equipment.
And
there's something in between, I can show that.
Always, yeah.
And then you've got these. This is a big weight or turbine.
That's pretty amazing what you can run around.
Now we're gonna go back in military.
Just go back and let's jump into the game because that's the game we're talking about.
And it's like
check the capacity.
There aren't.
There aren't. So,
by the way, the music in this game is amazing. Oh, look at that. There's the tutorial mission.
This is my hat. This is her hat. She's my boss, I think.
And she's going to explain to me how this game works. Oh, Heather.
Oh, office manager. She's not my boss. I'm her boss.
So only if you haven't played this game before. Well, then you can suck it, Heather. Look at it. This is a little truck. And, yeah. We're gonna go and do something else. Because I'm not interested. Gosh, I used to play this so much. I used to have a laptop over by the TV and on a carton box, and I would play games there while watching TV. Yes, I was a very dynamic kid. Not really. There's a Rosa. Always honk the Rosas. They're amazing peeps. As you can see, comparing with the other game, the graphics are a little bit better. We can still not look up and down. We can only look side to side. But the mirrors are animated. Oh god! And we've got a fan, and we've got a little thing hanging in the middle. And they tried to make it more fun, and I think it worked out pretty well. And we're driving with a little truck. Oh, honka colleagues. There's a little thing there, and. Just a big map. Is there a little map? And basically you can show yourself the custom checks and the scales, which in the last video we had a problem with. Well, here they are. And you can basically, I don't want those. I don't want those. I don't want that. I'm not interested. I just want to know where I can buy a truck. Well, then you click that on and then click everything off. Like that. And you can see, oh yeah, there's a truck dealer. There's a truck dealer, and there's a little bit of Canada in here, and we're on the edge of South America, and the map is indeed bigger on the other game, but as you can see, there's a lot to see, and since you always have to start off in San Francisco, well, we will. We will. We'll have to. Oh, there is a mini-map. I was just too blind to see. So now we can check our mirrors, and when we were going to overtake someone. That's how you have to drive. You have to check your middle mirror, then your right mirror, and then you have to indicate, actually, and then you have to check them again. But there's way too much work for in a game, so we're not going to. And now we can't overtake, so your place on the road is the right lane, so we're going to go to the right lane, except if you're in England, because then your place on the road is the left lane. Oh, road rules. Driving in traffic. There are some real-esque based cars in this game. I guess we'll see a Mustang today, probably somewhere. Also, there are a lot more modern cars in this game. So actually, we had to indicate right there, but I don't know where my indicators are, which is interesting. I just put my engine off, check the mirror, and go into the lane. So you have to check the mirror and then, you know, put your indicator on. So I'm going to go into the pass screen and find out where am I. Oh, it's a bit slow. Let's see. Controls, options. Controls, let's see, indicator. Drive by, those are the cameras, horn. Four-way flasher is the F. Oh, left and right turn signals are the hooks. I don't want them there. So, left.
It's gonna be left. And right. It's gonna be right. Awesome. Okay. Because I play with WASD. So now right should be indicating. Don't know, do we have to stop here? Don't think so. It's working, but it's not clicking inside the car. Which is really annoying, because then I don't know if my indicator... Don't forget to put your... Why is high beam on? I don't want high beam. It is high beam. What the fuck, where are we going? This is going well. So, the green things are normal deliveries, and the yellow things are missions. As a brief explanation, so missions are like going into a building site with a trailer, and you have to back up the trailer into the building site, but it's really annoying and really hard to do because there's a lot of crap that you have to maneuver around. Those are the missions. They're really interesting, but I guess we're going to be focusing on delivering loads. Now we're coming up to our orange thing, it's a gas station. Now we don't need gas, we need diesel, but I guess we're pretty good. We're going in miles, which is handy because we're in America. Born in the USA! Yeah. Okay. Alright. A colleague. Colleague trucker. I guess we could go out there and buy a truck. I mean, we've got $10,000. See, I'm not... Look, this is undertaking. You're not allowed to do that. Don't do that, kids. Don't do. So yeah, it's a pretty game. It's pretty detailed, actually, and I like the way the detail builds up. And now you actually have to drive onto the sidewalk. I think that's kind of twisted, actually. So what do you say? Should we drive this truck around and just, you know, do some stuff with it? Or should we actually go and buy a new truck in the beginning of the game? I think that's pretty... Oh, look, I was wanted there for a little bit. Because I'm not sure. Oh, we're on the tram rail. Oh, come on. You're not allowed to drive on the tram rail. Kids, don't try that at home. And on brakes. Oh god. It's pretty direct in steering. So we're going that way. I thought I had right of way. I hadn't. No! No! I didn't have right of way. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. So yeah, I've got no idea when my indicators are on or not on. We have to check with two. Oh, we can't go off there. It's the first time in a while that I'm playing this game again. Look at the detail of it. Look at that, Toyota Supra. Tuned to look fine. By the way, speaking about Supras, which are tuned, this game always made me think of another game that you might know of, which is Need for Speed Underground 2, which is my favorite Need for Speed in the series. And yeah, if you know it, please let me know, because then we can talk about it and have a fun time. Right. Lord, the reverse line. He's putting his warning lights on when you're going back out. So we can go to Roswell, Las Vegas, Washington, and that's it. It's a hospital. I don't really want to drive waste. But then again, so looking on the map, let's say, where is it? City names. Las Vegas is right there, and San Francisco is right here. Now you'd say that's quite a small distance if you have, you know, seen me drive the other game. But actually, the roads have been lengthened a little bit, so it's a little bit harder to drive that distance. But we're gonna do. I think we're gonna go to Las Vegas for a first drive. And actually, thinking about it, that's a pretty big distance to drive for, you know, truck dealer. Oh, there, I'm like on top of a truck dealer. Sorry. Okay. Yeah. Let's go and drive to Las Vegas. Yeah, that's okay. Later. So do I earn the money before I'm gonna drive or after? Don't cry. No, you earn the money after you delivered your load. It's like having a child, really. But I think the shine detail is really awesome in this game. It's not as reflecting as I thought it would. Okay, awesome. So indicating, driving onto the road. Oh, the mouse is really sensitive, I'm sorry. So now you can go and step into the truck, cab, and have no idea that you're carrying a load. So we can have a look in the truck dealer. But it's basically the same as the showroom in the menu. So yeah, oh. Used to indicating. Oh god! It's okay. I'm okay at least. Damage to the truck, not to the trailer. Yeah. The place on the road is right. We're going to drive in the middle lane because we're going to overtake this sucker. Oh, he's driving in the middle lane. Had to check my mirrors there. So indicate, have a look, he's not there, and click off that. Alright, as you can see the truck dealer is over there, so we're going to have a look. And yeah, you will be the ones to decide whether I buy a truck or not. And I'm going to make this thing a series. After this episode I'm going to make another episode of the other game. And I'm going to show you why I like this game and why I dislike that game. Oh, I can't go there. Yeah, I'm a scrub. Am I indicating? I don't know. Yeah, I'm in. Go off. I'm not allowed to undertake someone. We're on the wrong road to go there. That's a fine air quarter. Are you not gonna take me for that? Come on. Come on, you booger. You booger. So I'm still indicating. It's really annoying that you don't hear the clicky sound that that indicators normally make. It's pretty annoying. Yeah, I've talked about Need for Speed Underground 2 already. Now, graphics-wise, it doesn't look like that game so much, but... Where can we turn off? Exactly? I think it's here. I mean... Ah, there we go. It's not really the way, I think, but... Oh, we're not allowed to drive that. No, 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 no. Meow. You're another sheep. Act normal. Bastard. So. Why am I getting fined? Why? Why do you hate me? What did I do wrong? Well, on another truck.
Right.
We're still in San Francisco. That's one thing that started to annoy me when I progressed in this game. I was driving a lot, but I wasn't going very fast. So if someone can take the complete map of this game and replace it into Need for Speed or something, that would be great. So you can drive quickly from city to city, because the distances that you have to travel aren't actually that big. You're just driving very slowly. I'm popping out of the cab every time I have to indicate, because I don't know whether I left it on or... So just change the controls. And I'm using the standard controls, because I'm used to the standard controls. Oh, here it is. Okay. Amazing. Okay, so this is a truck dealer. Just enter. And now we can take a look at another truck. And then... Do you want it? Yes, I want it, but how much does it cost? Or are the trucks for free? You know what? For now, I'm gonna buy it. Sort of. But it's a pretty odd that you can just take the trailer. I mean, I just took the truck. Do you want the stock truck? Yes, of course I want a stock truck. Weird. Very old. But oh well, I guess. Yeah. So this is it. Welcome in the Pacific. We now have an engine block hanging from the middle of the truck. This is a more classic design truck. Oh god, this is not a one-way road, is it? It is. And they're gonna hate me for this. I'm gonna be killed by the police because I'm driving on the wrong side of the road. I'm driving on the wrong side of the road. It's not right, matey. It's not right. This is a one-way street, and actually, they didn't fine me for that. Wow. America's police, everybody. America's police. No indicating nor anything. I'm terrible. So, I've got no idea how long I'm filming now, but rock that rocks. Okay, I remember these signs and stuff all being much more blurry. That's amazing. I like it. What annoys me though is that I can't see my bonnet, and in most trucks of this size you would be able to. It's really weird. Hello, copper. I'm playing this with a controller, I'm playing this with the keyboard and mouse. Oh, whoops. Oh. Still a pretty hard game to play. And that's a hotel, I think. You can sleep there, obviously. We're not gonna. Because the night is actually not that terrible in this game. Now there are some weird bugs in this game too. You can drive on water, I found out. So the trucks are Jesus in this game. All trucks are. I don't know if cars are, but trucks are Jesus. Which is amazing. Nah, I like it. I mean, look, there's a Mustang. A Ford Mustang convertible. And a Rosa, a copper. And there's a Ford Transit, which is really weird because Transits were never sold in America. And when I first found that out, I'm a car enthusiast, so I was just going mad about it. But it doesn't really matter. I mean, come on, it doesn't matter that much. Now, the place that I drove on water with a truck was actually Miami or Orlando, Florida. Miami, Florida, of course. But this beach looks quite the same, same build-up. It's not weird. I mean, why would they design a different beach tent for every single beach? I mean, it's not the real world, come on. But if you were wondering, yes, you can drive off the world. And no, it's not nice. There's not a big pot of gold on the end of the world or something. If you might think that. We're behind a Ford Transit pickup truck. And we're not allowed to overtake him.
Wait,
oh, that's camera. How do you do cruise control in this damn thing?
Not V.
Okay, let's resort to the title screen. Not the title screen, the options menu. Controls. Motor brake is the thing here. We can try that. B. Cruise controls R, because that's logic. I don't actually know what motor brake is, but oh well.
And we have cruise control, which was R.
I have no idea what 33 miles an hour means. I mean, it's an indication of speed, yes, but that's how far it gets to me.
Santa Cruz.
Let's have a look at the map. Oh, we have to zoom manually. Santa Cruz. City names. Come on.
So yeah, let's go left here.
And go all the way down to Los Angeles and then go to Las Vegas. And we actually will pass a truck dealer, but since we've already got a truck, we don't really need it. And we could either have gone around the top to Reno and to Las Vegas, or down the bottom. And I think down the bottom, I don't know. Both could be good. I don't know. Okay. So let's move on. Let's go and have a good time. Let's indicate to the left here. Yeah. The police still likes me, so I didn't overtake the law. Yeah, of course. Of course I overtook the law. Jesus, speaking is hard today. It's 12 o'clock in the morning and I have the biggest trouble. Oh. Hello. Thank you. Okay, let's have a look at the map again. Where do we want to go? We are in Santa Cruz. Yeah, we want to take a big left here. But I don't actually know which left to... never mind, there's only one left to take, and it's not this one. And now we have to stop, probably. Our motor brake actually works. Okay. I still have no idea what it is. I think it's not such a phenomenon in the normal car driving world. I do know that you can brake on the motor, but I've got no idea if that's actually the same thing. But I think, because this is automatic. And basically what happens when you drive is you just release the gas pedal and your car starts slowing down because the engine's revs are going slower than the wheels are rotating. So the engine's revs are actually forcing the wheels to go slower. That's, I think, motor braking. But it could be that there's just a big disc brake on your flywheel on which two brake pads are just having their way. It either way works for me, but I've got no idea what a motor brake is. But I think it's just, you know, forcing your revs lower than the car's driving. Oh, look at that! A wallet is actually sliding across the dashboard. Oh yeah, I remember that. I always try to get the wallet to fall off the dashboard. It's the only bit of game you have in this game. Simulator, I think. It's funny how a game in which the only thing you have to do is driving a truck, it's become so popular, because when you look at it, you take an incredibly mundane thing, which is driving a car or a truck, and then you go and simulate that. Okay, for some people it's really stressy driving a car. I mean, even for me. No, what am I saying, even? It's not even. But for me too. I'm having lessons in how to drive a car, and sometimes it's really stressy. But then again, traffic in the Netherlands, it's not great. I mean, it's awful actually. It's bloody awful. Well, let's have a look at the map. Yes, it can be really stressy driving a car. Yeah, we just have to move on this highway. Yeah, it just is. And, you know, the traffic in here is actually pretty, it's pretty stable, it's pretty simple traffic. But in the Netherlands, everything is so much smaller, but the cars are about the same size. And if you have to cram more of the same size in a smaller space, you're gonna get really stressy situations, like really stressy. I'm checking my mirrors. Can I check my indicator in the mirror? I don't think so. So you're gonna overtake and then you're gonna slow down, because of course that's what you do. Oh god, no, no! Of course you do that. Why do you stamp on the brake? Why? Why do you all of a sudden go and decide it's better to stay still on the highway? Because that's a good idea or something. You're a dick, mister. And then he starts to drive again, the fucking police car. Come here, you rosa. I'll get you. We're an annoying bunch of bastards. Annoying bunch. I'm still indicating to the right. Like, I don't like to brag, but I'm happy there's one person on the road who can drive. Bloody traffic. I don't hope all the Americans drive like this, because then in a country that has so many cars, if all people drive like this, that's gonna be crazy. Oh, sorry. Well, I guess there's nobody on the road who can drive. Another truck. What the fuck is happening with this taxi? Oh, shut up! I don't want to talk to you. I don't like you, and I don't want to like you. I don't want to know you either. I don't want to know you either. That was the same line twice. So So we've got a gas station on the right and the truck dealer on the left, because that's logic. Yeah, I'm going to go and indicate, not for you, your viewing pleasure, but just to learn myself the good rules of driving the road. Okay, and ding ding ding. Oh my god. Wow. Wow. So creeping onto the road, motorway or highway or low way or no way. It's a way, I'm sure. Q&A. It's also ending with an A. And an I. Q&A. Questions and answers. No shit. And the other thing I couldn't read. On the right we have sneakers. They're not just sneakers, they are blurry sneakers. Feeling. Yeah. Place it a little bit higher next time so I can actually read. Mbank. I like Mbank better. What does the stop sign say? Final block of prime production seats released. What the is that about? So this is Los Angeles. Welcome.
Welcome to Los Angeles. Where everybody is dressed in bikinis. And whores are nowhere to be found. Only on television.
Jokes. Oh, shut up. I don't feel like listening to you. Or talking to you, or anything. So, I think it's pretty apparent that, English is not my native language. And I'm making quite some mistakes, and sometimes I can't make out my words, and I'm just, you know, doing my thing here. Albuquerque. Oh yeah,
that's what the
driving instructor was on about. If you start right and drive, unlike someone next to you who's gonna hate you for cutting him off. That was what he was on about. What he was on about. Jeez, my speaking, it has some trouble. Yep, I think I'm already playing for like half an hour, and if I am, I'm very sorry, but my truck won't go any faster. But this is exactly what I meant. In about the time that we could go across almost complete America, in this game it takes us that time to go from one city to another, because the trucks are slower, the world is bigger, and I'm driving on a lane that's not meant for driving on. So yeah, if you're still feeling like watching, then congratulations, you're still in the video. If not, yeah. Oh well. So I'm now looking at random stuff in my room to talk about, because, you know, that's how that works. Words are no longer making sense, sentences are broken off. And it's actually in the morning. I can't say early in the morning, because when I stood up it was like 12 o'clock. So, yeah. Can we use that gap to overtake the bus? We're just gonna try. We're gonna hear a big bang when we can't. Just have a look. Yeah, it's enough space. Had indicator off, I hope. Let's have a look.
Yeah.
Indicators are off.
Yay!
Now this is interesting. Look, a nuclear power station! Yay! Yay! Now the managing part of this game is not so in depth. It's actually they haven't taken any time to go into the managing part of the game. They just went there and made a game. And I think you can hire people to make money for you. I'm not entirely sure, but in Euro Truck Simulator 2, you are actually allowed to do that sort of stuff, so that's amazing. And you're actually able to work with quite a good managing system too. It works pretty cool, pretty good. Which is a game we're going to be looking at shortly after, you know, I've had all of these games. As I said, I'm going to play one more of these games, and then I think one is going to be a recurring series. But seeing that making a delivery takes a life in the year or something, this is probably not going to be a series. I mean, It doesn't really work now, does it? Now here I am in my truck, overtaking a tuned Toyota Supra because he's not going fast enough. How twisted is that? Oh well, I guess. Now there are quite some extensive mods for this game. Quite some people have tried to make good mods for this game, and I might be having a look into that. I'm not sure, but I think it's a very pretty game. There he goes in the Supra, and you know, we might have a look into the modding part of this game. I have no idea how it works modding this game. So we're probably not going to have a look into it, because I simply can't be arsed. Can't be arsed. Look at that, an airplane. Keep your eyes on the road, everybody. We're still driving a truck. So I can say to you that if you want a good... If you want to watch a series about, you know, this type of game, then I think you're quite weird. But if you want to play this game, I can only say to you, props to you, because this is a very fun series. Really it is. It's just not fun to watch. And, you know, it's not super detailed. Not at all. And I've just hit the wall. I didn't know weighing would sound like that. Oh well. Yeah. So, if you want to play the game, I can totally understand. I mean, why not? If you want to watch a series about it, I think that's pretty weird. Pretty odd. Can we go? We've got room. Put the indicator on. We're actually on the emergency lane. Have a look at the mirror again. And we're going to be overtaken by something that looks like a Euro box. It is. Euro box. Is it becoming night again? Yeah, it's becoming night time again. But we're rolling into Las Vegas at last. Our truck has served us well, which is awesome. I like that. Now you can also tune your truck, but for that you need to go Oh god, we're splitting up. Well, we're going to the right, so we'll stay in the right. You can also, you know, modify your truck. You can take different color schemes. You can choose just normal colors for it. You can put new engines into it, new gearboxes, new brakes, new drivetrains, I think. And you can just basically make it a lot faster. You can't do anything with... Yeah, you can have accessories like a bug shield, I think they call it. It's like a small glass pane on the nose of your truck. And you can take, I think, new mirrors and antennas and spoilers and stuff, but you can't do anything with the wheels. All the wheels of all the trucks are exactly the same. But you can modify your truck, which is pretty awesome. Let's have a look if we can, you know, find on the map. We've got services. I think it's in services. Oh, we can actually have a look at services. So where's the white? The white dot is right there somewhere. Well, then we're just going to go and have a look. We can. The road is quite empty. Yeah, we're driving right past it, so... Don't do that in real life. Just don't. So just brake, 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 and enter. Oh, this is just repairing the truck. Okay, that's good to know. Thanks a lot, mate. So they've repaired my truck, but that's not really what I went in there for. I thought the blue was sleeping. Oh, come on. But it could be that that's the modifying shop. Yeah, blue looks like sleeping, so... And the orange, you know, the orange thing is... filling it up. Diesel. So, back to the map. It's not services. And truck stops. I think it's a truck stop that I'm looking for. And there's one right there. That's not where we came from. And there's one in San Francisco, actually. Yeah, that's where you can, that's possibly where you can modify a truck. So I might stick a little bit to the end. No, I'm not. You're just gonna have to believe me. It's a truck stop. That's where you can, you know, repair the truck, not repair the truck, but modify the truck, which is awesome. Believe me. You're gonna have to take my word for it. That's actually a double trailer in front of us. IRL, but I don't know if you can actually take another trailer and hitch it onto it. You'd have to be very good in backing up trucks to be able to do that. There's a big guitar. I love guitars. So I guess we'll just drive on to the end of the road, sort of, and then you know, we're going to go right and we're going to finish the drive. Now also I can remember in one of these cities, you know, having a mission that would have you race around in a small van, taking also in a Ford Transit with a big box on the back, which has you collect I think it's hand out towels or something to hotels and stuff. You have to race around Las Vegas with that little van. And you have to, you know, deliver your stuff. But the catch is, if you drive the thing at top speed, your truck, your little van will actually collect damage. So you can't take it all the way. You'll have to, you know, watch out for your speed. That's the catch with that little mini game, little mission. There's also a bus driving mission in this game, which has you driving around in one of those green school buses. Why they're green, I don't know, but they are. So, You'll have to live with that. Oh, come on. So, indicate, go, right. And I started in second, so I have to end up in the second lane. See, it's terrible. And somewhere here where you picked up a little van, and I think it was in Las Vegas. Yep. And now we're gonna undertake someone. Get a move on, you bastard. Okay, so... I think you are really tough if you're still watching the video. I would probably already have clicked away if I was watching this video, because I'm quite a boring person, if I do say so myself. So if you have the patience to watch through this video, props to you, mate. Props to you. I wouldn't be able to. So I thought it would be fun to have a little episode, little mini-series running, you know, with a little clock. I've got a little clock stuck onto my microphone on which I can, you know, it's like a stopwatch basically. But it's not that I forgot to turn it on, it's like I was halfway into the video and then I was like, wait, I can time my video. So yeah, that's something. 45. Does this thing do 45? Now the little orange bits, I mean, this game is called Wheels of Steel Convoy, and the orange things on the map are actually other trucks, which is cool, because convoy, you know what a convoy is a big row of trucks driving together, and it's not a goal in the game, it's more like a feature. You can actually drive with your truck behind another truck, and then have a convoy of two. And you could set yourself the goal of driving with about four or five people in a big row. Come on. So it's now going to show an icon somewhere. Yeah, look, in the top middle of the screen, there's now a little icon showing that we're driving in a convoy of two. Now, my maximum convoy that I've driven in was five, but that's because I went to a truck stop, because only trucks go into a truck stop, like, you know, those carpool places. And, you know, I just stopped my truck from driving, and then other trucks would queue up behind me. It's R. Come on. Come on, you bastard. So, yeah, this is cruise control. This is convoy, I mean... I'll have to go left soon, so... Honk my good friend. And now comes the game part of this game. Now there's one more thing I want to figure out before I, you know, go and do... Try to back the trailer in. Which is, do I have a CB radio like I had in the last game? Because I do want to talk, actually. I think... Trailer attach, motor brake, cruise control, start stop engines, wiper, engines, like I have two. Left turn signal, right turn signal, four-way flasher, on... Parking brake, inside camera, inside, free rotate camera, that's like what I'm in right now, bumper cam, top cam, drive-by cam. Okay, so I don't... And that's if you have a steering wheel or something. That's it. Then we've got sound, audio, we've got gameplay. What does gameplay say? Language English. Can we put it in? Oh, okay. Navigation map, that's like the, yeah. Oh, we can actually put it in KPH, but I want transmission automatic, view distance. Okay, we can actually make that bigger. How cool is that? So now, I think I made it smaller. I'm not going to be tinkering with that. I don't know what that means. So, we also have a top-down camera, which then changes to that one going backwards. What I like to do is just go right there. Oh, and we'll just take... It's old school GTA, basically. And now we'll slowly roll the truck into position. Like this. And it must be kind of straight in front of it. And then we'll just pull the trailer out. Until the trailer is straight behind the truck. And I... I'll actually look behind the truck. So we'll go into two. And as you can see, what my plan was has completely failed. But I guess that we can do this. Yeah, we did it. Okay. I've had harder times trying to park a trailer, so that's... amazing. Look at that, that's we. That's us, not we. That's us. That's a we! Look at that, that's a we! Okay. Thanks for the delivery. The overall damage penalty is $69. I will pass that to my account. Yay, we made money! Awesome. Ooh. New accessory available, yay. Great backing bonus. Ah, thank you. That's so nice. So, yeah, that's that. I'm driving around with the parking brake on, yay. I'm always trying if I'm able to do burnouts and stuff. I'm not. Okay. Oh well. It's been... I basically took too much of your time, so I'm now going to sign off, and I hope you have enjoyed this little Let's Play thing. I certainly did. And I will see you next time, in which we're going to play 18 Wheels of Steel Long Haul, I think it's called. And then we're going to do Extreme Trucker, and then we're going to be doing a look at that, the spars of the truck. Great. And then we're going to be doing Euro Truck Simulator 2. Which is that's probably going to be a series, because I actually like to play that game. Not that I don't like to play this game, but that's a bit odd. Right, so yeah, I'll catch you all later. Bye.